Welcome to the chapter Fibre to Fabric.
This slide presents the overview of the chapter. Learning objectives. By the end of this chapter, you will be able to
explain the processing of silk from silk moth. Draw the life cycle of the silk moth. List the conditions for rearing silkworms. Discuss the uses of silk. Explain the processing of wool fabric. Draw the flowchart for the processing of wool fiber. Discuss the use.
Introduction. Before entering into the chapter, follow the instructions shown on the screen. Click each tab to know more.
Generally, we know that clothing is a basic necessity of life and clothes provide protection against the climate. We also studied that clothes are made from some fibers obtained from plants and animals. Do you know which fibers are obtained from plants and animals? Which part of the animal is useful to make fabrics? Let us find out the answers to such questions in this chapter. Introduction to animal fibers. In lower classes, we studied that the cotton, jute, gongura, coconut plant fibers are useful in making different kinds of fabrics. In the same way, we get fibers of silk and wool from animals. Silk fiber is obtained from the salivary secretions of silkworm, while wool fiber is obtained from the fleece or hair of sheep, goat, yak, camel, etc. Now, let us learn in detail the process involved in making fabrics from these animal fibers. Production of silk. Silk fibers are obtained from animal fibers. That is, silkworms spin the silk fibers. There are various steps involved in silk production. The whole process of obtaining silk, starting from silk moth, is called sericulture. Mainly four stages are involved in the process of silk production. They are moth to egg, egg to cocoon, cocoon to fiber, reeling to weaving. Click each tab to know more. Moth to egg. In the production of silk, moths are collected and those moths are kept in grill mesh boxes in separate rooms. These silk moths are also known as Bombyx mori and some people call them Chilakalu. The moths lay hundreds of eggs, which are very small in size, and the eggs of silk moth worms are called seeds. Note, a female moth lays around 500 eggs in one go and dies. People allow these eggs or seeds to hatch in special chambers like over mats, on beds of chopped mulberry leaves to get small worms. Sometimes, people buy silk moths to produce eggs in some places. The places at which silk moths are sold are called greenages. The biggest growing center is located at Horsley Hills in Chittoor district. Here the eggs of silk moth worms are stored carefully on the strips of cloth or paper and then sold to the silk farmers. Egg to cocoon. Silk farmers keep the eggs or seeds under hygienic conditions and at a suitable temperature. After some time, these eggs hatch into larvae, which are also known as caterpillars or silkworms. The tiny and white-colored silkworms or caterpillars are placed in the trays along with freshly chopped mulberry leaves. These worms eat the mulberry leaves almost continuously. During feeding, each caterpillar sheds its skin four times and becomes bigger in size. After 30 to 35 days, the caterpillars stop eating and settle at a particular place. At this time, these worms are transferred into big-sized cane frames called chendrikalu. Now, a caterpillar weaves a net to hold itself by moving its mouth from side to side and produces a fiber-like substance. This substance becomes strong when it is exposed to air and heat. This net looks like a closed sack and covers the whole body of the caterpillar. This is called cocoon or larva, pottukayalu. If the cocoons are left to themselves, the cocoons develop into moths and fly away. When the moths come out from the cocoon, the thread gets damaged. So, farmers kill the larva inside the cocoon by a process called stifling by putting a lot of cocoons in a steam oven for 10 to 15 minutes. Stifling process helps to store the cocoons for a long time, and this process is usually done in reeling centers. These cocoons are kept in sealed bags and sold at the cocoon market. Majorly, cocoons markets are located at Hindupur, Madanapalli, Dharmavaram, Kadiri, Palamaneru, Raichoti and Hyderabad. Cocoon to fiber. In this stage, a pile of cocoons are collected and boiled in water to kill the larva or pupae inside the cocoon. Here the boiling water not only kills the insects inside the cocoon, but also dissolves a gummy substance that holds the cocoons. At that time, the cocoons are dried and brushed to remove the coarse outer portion, which consists of coarse filaments. Now, the silk thread is collected from the cocoons by a process called reeling the silk. Reeling is done with special machines called reelers and twisters. The resulting silk fiber is carefully collected from the cocoon, and nearly 3 to 18 of such threads are wound together to make yarn from it, which is reeled. This yarn is called raw silk and it can be dyed into various colors. Silk fibers are then spun into silk threads, which are woven into a variety of silk fabrics by weavers. Mainly, the reeling centers are located at places such as Nandikotkur, Hyderabad, Karimnagar, etc. In only a few days, a single silkworm spins a cocoon from which a silk thread up to 600 meters in length can be removed. However, it still takes about 2,500 cocoons to make half a kilogram of silk. Reeling to weaving. The processing of silk is the twisting of one or more threads of raw silk into a strand sufficiently strong for weaving or knitting. This procedure is called throwing. People weave silk fabric by using silk yarn on hand looms, which is their traditional occupation. These people get the silk yarn from the reeling centers to weave a variety in saris. Pochampalli Pattu and Dharmavaram are famous types of saris produced by our state. Pochampalli Pattu is also called tie and dye or jamdani. Dharmavaram is famous for its wide border and rich butta or dots. Pochampalli is the place where threads and colors find their way into the hands of skillful weavers and menders into the market as beautiful saris and dress material as the most typical weaving material. Pochampalli is also known as the Silk City of India. Banaras, Kanchipuram, Narayanpet, Kottakota, Pochampalli are all types of silk fabrics which get their names from the places where they are made. Apart from that, there are some more varieties of silks based on the moth species such as Tasar silk, Muga silk, Kosa silk, Eri silk and so on. People involved in the process suffer from skin as well as respiratory problems due to continuous handling of the silkworm and the silk fibers. Uses of silk. Silk is mostly used for making saris, dresses and scarves. It is also used to make products like satin and crepe, and also used to make products like parachutes, bicycle tires, bulletproof vests, and non-absorbable sutures in surgery. Silk fabric is lightweight, lustrous, soft, elastic, and highly strong in tensile strength. The flowchart of life cycle of silkworm is shown on the screen. Here, we will discuss the story of wool. Wool is used for making woolen clothes like sweaters, mufflers, long coats, hats, table covers, etc. Mainly, wool is obtained from the fleece of domesticated animals like sheep. Apart from sheep, wool also comes from the Angora goat, yak, llama, alpaca, and even camels. All these animals have a thick coat of hair or fleece which keeps them warm. Wool is obtained from this fleece. Sheep wool is more commonly red on large farms in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat. In Tibet and Ladakh, yak wool is more common, whereas the Angora wool is common in Jammu and Kashmir. The famous Pashmina shawls come from the soft underfur of the Kashmiri goat. The llama and the alpaca are two animals that yield wool in South America. Now, let us know the processing of wool fiber. In the processing of wool fiber, shearing is the first step, which is the removal of the fleece of the sheep along with a thin layer of the skin. It is done manually with clippers or a pair of scissors. The person who removes the wool is called a shearer. It can also be done by using a shearing machine. Now, the sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed with some chemicals, detergent and alkali in steam water tanks and stirred with a spade to remove grease, dust and dirt. This process is called washing or scouring. Nowadays, it is done by machines. After washing, the hairy skin is sent to a factory where hair of different textures are separated or sorted according to their texture and type. This process is called sorting or wool classing. Since the fibers are mostly black, brown or white in color, they can now be bleached and dyed with various colors based on the requirements. Once the dyeing process is complete, the sourced woolen fibers are dried and then disentangled. Now, these fibers are then combed to straighten them by a carding machine. This process is called carding. From there, a machine rolls and pulls it out into a thick rope and still another pulls and twists it into a long thread or yarn. This is the process of spinning. These resultant long threads of yarn are used for making woolen fabric so as to form interlocking loops and rings of woolen yarn. Note: the wool can be dyed at any stage after washing or spinning or knitting. Apart from the handmade process of knitting, hand looms and power looms are also used to make woolen fabric from woolen yarn. In the hand looms or power looms, the woolen threads are stretched from the top of loom to the bottom. These threads are called warp threads. The threads that go side to side are weft threads. A shuttle like a big needle takes the weft threads over and under warp threads. One more important part of the loom is the harness. The harness lifts every other warp thread so that the weft threads go over one and under the next. All types of yarn, whether cotton or silk or wool, etc., are woven in this manner. The flowchart given on the screen shows the process involved in obtaining wool to produce fabric. Wool can be used for various purposes. Now, let us discuss some of them. Wool is used for making fabrics like shawls, blankets, carpets and upholstery. Wool felt is used for table covers. Wool is also used as flame retardant because it self-extinguishes when burnt. Wool absorbs water slowly, allowing the wearer to feel dry. Think and discuss. Why is blanket wrapped around a person who is caught in a fire? A blanket is a highly flame-resistant material that can be used to either extinguish a small fire or to wrap around a person. They are made from the layers of woolen fiber fabric which cuts off the oxygen supply and smothers the fire. Follow-up work. Collect pieces of silk cloth of various types and paste them in your scrapbook. You can find them in a tailor shop among the heap of waste cut pieces. Prepare a scrapbook with pictures of animals whose hair is used as wool. You have successfully completed the chapter Is Fibre to Fabric?